choose to believe will determine our destiny, okay? What you choose to believe will determine your destiny. What we choose to think about. So, you know, one thing that I do tell young people, I love to read and I love that they read, but it is important what we do read, because Proverbs 4:23 says, I think I've got this right, I know it's Proverbs 4, above all else, guard your heart, for out of it is the wellspring of life. So we're guarding what we put into our mind, just like we guard what we put into our mouth. We wouldn't eat dog poop, right? So why would you read that and put that into your soul? So when I hear people that say they love God, and yet they're continuously reading stuff that is demonic, Stephen King, if I need to point fingers, I will. Because when I was a teenager, I read a lot. I could name them. They were just coming out. You know, he used to write under a different name. That's not his name. Trust me when I say what he's writing is demonic. Demons are writing this. So why would you, you know, the scripture says you cannot eat at the table of the Lord and at the table of demons. Why would you do that? Saying that it's going to cost you your salvation, but it will cost you your victorious walk. How can we be victorious? It's like, how can I feel good if I get up and drink poison for breakfast? I'm going to feel terrible that day. So it's the same way. So it's not really, I didn't come on here to pick on any particular person. I'm just saying, I have personal experience with this author, and I can tell you this is demonic. And demons are probably even writing this stuff. So I just had someone in church post on Facebook about how they were so excited about all these new books. And I was like, I can't believe that you would, number one, say that, think that, or read that. Because this is my post and I get to say what I want. No, it's not true. I don't always get to say exactly what I want. Yeah, but I'm going to tell you the situation. There was a young woman that I adored. In fact, I was at her birth, and she was, this when Facebook was pretty new. She was on Facebook, and she posted. She's not only is she a Christian, she was a leader in at college for Chi Alpha, which is an Assembly of God ministry on campus. Right? She's in leadership, and she posts this song on Facebook. This young man singing the song was using God's name in vain. He would say God's name in vain, and then he would say something about him. He was so infatuated with this woman, and he loved her. You know, when I was a teenager, you couldn't play stuff like that on the radio. They didn't. You didn't use God's name on the radio. Of course, you didn't use the F word and stuff like that either. The airwaves were a little more younger and tenderer, I guess. So on her Facebook page, I said, honey, why would you listen to this? They're using God's name in vain. That's one of the Ten Commandments. Thou shalt not use the Lord thy God's name in vain. That's right up there with don't kill, don't steal, don't lie. Why would you be so infatuated with this? She said, I just love this song. I said, why would you even listen to this song? Let alone think that you like this song. This person is cursing God. And she unfriended me. And her sister, who's older, who's one of my daughter's very dear friends, says to me, she gets on there and says to me, well, I don't think that would tempt her to use God's name in vain. I said, it's not about that. It's about what you're choosing to bring into your heart and your life. It changes you. And if you hear this over and over again, what's in your heart will seep out or leak out of your mouth. Matthew 6, Jesus said, what's in your mouth is going to, what's in your heart is going to come out your mouth. What's in your heart actually is Spirit, right? He is with us. He is cheering us on. He loves us. He's crazy about us. Well, you know, don't grieve the Holy Spirit by saying things that hurt other people. This is interesting. I'm almost to church, but going slow. The public schools right here. Getting to pray for these kids as I pass them. She was just talking about how different people in her life, in her school life, had, like when she wanted to go to college, she wanted to be an architect, and the counselor said, oh, you'll never do this, you're not smart enough, and there only 5% of the people graduate and never get a job, and you'll never do this. So she didn't go to college. She didn't even go to college to do that. She's very successful, and she was a successful banker, but you know, she could have been a successful architect. But the counselor at college told her she was dumb, and she wasn't dumb. She's very, very intelligent. Anyway, my point is, what is my point? Today, let us choose to agree with God. So when God says, let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, Ephesians 4, let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good and helpful to edify other people. Today I'm going to choose to agree with God, and I'm going, if Jesus said, if you love me, you will obey me. So today I'm going to obey what Jesus has already said. He's made clear in the Ten Commandments, thou shalt not sleep with your neighbor's wife. That's what he said. These things are good, that we would adhere to what Jesus is saying. Interesting fact. I wasn't there, and I don't know, but I have heard that the Ten Commandments was written on both sides of the stone. Charleston Heston missed that in the Ten Commandments, huh? Anyway, I think that's funny. But love you guys. I'm here. I'm 15 minutes late. So excited about getting to be with the kids and cheering them on. And they are just such a wonderful group of kids. Oh my goodness, they are just such a wonderful group of kids. Let me pray with you. Father, every time we pause and we acknowledge who you are and embrace your majesty, that is worship. We don't have to be singing to worship. We worship you because you are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy. Thank you, Lord. I just pray for anyone that's still listening. 9 minutes in. Touch our hearts. Help us to realize that obedience is better than sacrifice. And if we love you, we will obey you. Today I choose to agree with God. Amen.